Hi, my name is Ricardo Miranda, and I'm the CEO of MTHFR Doctors. Today, my purpose is to share with you how MTHFR and methylation can help you fight the coronavirus. I have written an article for the website, and I want everyone to read it. And I'm making this video very short just to explain this one element of how methylation is actually fighting the virus. So first, let's go back to the MTHFR methylation, the definition, for the people that haven't heard of these terms before. MTHFR stands for methylene tetrahydrofolate reductase. It's a gene that activates an enzyme by the same name that helps our body to break down folate and folic acid into a usable form of folate called methylene tetrahydrofolate. And this folate is the main fuel for a process in our body called methylation. So I'm going to try to speak in very simple terms to make it very easy for everyone to understand. So methylation is this complex biochemical process in our body that has many functions. One of the main functions is to regulate gene expression. It turns genes on and off. Another function is intracellular detoxification. Methylation helps our body to detoxify. Methylation also supports the immune system. And there are many other functions. Today, we're going to focus on the immune system, but more in particular, methylation directly fights viruses. Let's take a look at the coronavirus. Coronavirus has all these receptors that attach to receptor sites in molecules in your body. Methylation produces a methyl group. What is a methyl group? It's one carbon, three hydrogen. So these methyl groups, they get attached to the receptor sites in the coronaviruses. So this is how methylation directly fights the viruses. And it's all explained in the article with links to research studies proving this. So what happens on our body is methylation, when our body sees the virus, the body induces methylation to place the methyl groups in the receptor sites. And they start placing on all receptor sites on the virus. When that happens, the methyl groups will silence the viruses. So it prevents the viruses from replicating. It prevents the viruses from attaching to molecules in your body. So on a healthy person that has a healthy methylation and plenty of methyl groups, what happens is the methyl groups will attach to the virus, will silence the virus. That's why we have all these people that got tested positive, but they have no symptoms because they have a strong methylation. The methylation in their body, they had enough methyl groups to silence all the viruses and control, so they had no symptoms. All we need to make sure is we need to have more methyl groups than viruses. Now, what happens if someone, for example, has a mutation on the MTHFR gene and they lose their ability to metabolize folate and to produce enough folate to fuel methylation. So they are, chances are, they have low methylation and they have low levels of methyl groups in their body. So what happens is they're gonna have more viruses, they're replicating, they're gonna have more than methyl groups. They're not going to have enough methyl groups to silence. Eventually, the viruses will overwhelm our body and we'll get sick, we'll get ill, and we'll go to the hospital and have all the complications that we're seeing. But if the person is healthy, if they have a strong methylation, if they have more methyl groups than viruses, eventually we'll overwhelm the virus, we'll silence, we'll control, we'll become immune. And that's what happens with healthy individuals. And this is the number one factor that shows how methylation directly fights the coronavirus. Now, what are the steps that we need to do? The number one thing is we need to support our methylation. We need to make sure that we have a strong methylation. So we need to take a methylated form of folate. It's called methylfolate. Second thing, we need to take vitamin D. And the third thing, we need to take some curcumin. Now, I'm going to explain one thing. It's all written in the article. Vitamin D has been proven to be a very strong supplement that supports methylation. And we have research there for you to read. Curcumin also has been proven to support methylation. But where do you get curcumin from? From turmeric. Now, the curcumin is inside turmeric, but it needs to have a small amount of black pepper in order to extract the curcumin from turmeric. So the best thing is not for you to eat turmeric out there or try to put black pepper in there. Find a company that produces good quality that has to be a 95% turmeric and 5% black pepper. And that combination has been proven by research to extract the curcumin. So that's what you need. So the easiest way to do is just to take the right product. Vitamin D, you need enough vitamin D. How much is enough? Most labs, they have normal range of vitamin D from 30 to 100. But functional range, the optimal range, should be between 60 to 120. I like my patients to have their range between 80 and 100. That is the best range. And that's very important. There's many researches showing that vitamin D is even anti-cancer. Vitamin D helps the body fight so many diseases, and vitamin D supports methylation. Now, methylfolate, how much methylfolate do you need to take? Well, it depends. Depends on if you have an MTHFR mutation, if you don't have, and if you have a mutation, which one? That is why it's so crucial for everyone to get tested for MTHFR so you know exactly what mutation if you have or if you don't have. Remember, your genes are not gonna change in your lifetime. They never change. So whatever mutation you have or you don't have, it'll always be the same. So you always know for the rest of your life how much methylfolate you need to support to have a healthy methylation. So in the article, I placed a link to another article that I explain exactly how you calculate the amount of folate you need based on your mutation. So I want to make this video short to give you a chance to read through the entire article and learn. But basically, I have established a minimum amount of folate that you can start taking today, regardless if you have or if you don't have a mutation. Because if you take the minimum, at least you have some level of protection. If you have no mutation at all, that minimum could be enough. But if you have the worst mutation, once you get your results, and then you know to increase the dosage on your methylfolate. Now, I like to supplement not just with methylfolate alone. I like to have a complete formula with a methylated folate, a methylated B12, and other nutrients. But there are a lot of good companies out there with different formulas. You choose one that you like and make sure you have the methylated form of folate, and that's what you need. Now, if you're healthy and you have no health issues, no medical conditions, all you need to do is to supplement and to take these, and you should be okay. Now, if you have any health conditions, please consult an MTHFR expert and have them help you look at your particular situation and how much you take and whatever else you need to, because this can get complex. Now, the reason why you need to get tested also, because some people may say, well, what if I just take the highest dosage? Well, too much of a good thing, or any good thing, it's a bad thing. So there's always a range. So there's a minimum range, but there's also a maximum range. If you take the maximum dosage, but you don't have any mutation you don't need, it may throw your body into what we call over-methylation. And that may create other problems, and then may decrease your immune system in through different ways, and then may make things worse. That's why I have established the minimum that will help everyone. But once you get your tests, you will know how much you need to take. So everything is listed on the article for you to learn. And I'm gonna ask you also to share with everyone you know, to share with your friends and family. Our purpose should be to help as many people as we can right now. So please share this video on all your social media, and let's see if we can reach as many people as we can, help them support their methylation, and you can start supporting me right away. Thank you so much.